Welcome to Desktop Deployment Essentials, our series designed to help you plan and make the shift to the latest Windows 10 release, whether you're coming from Windows 7, Windows 8, or a previous version of Windows 10. Windows 7 end of support is just around the corner in January 2020. And if you haven't made a lot of progress on your Windows 10 upgrade, the resources highlighted in this series are designed to help with the tools you're probably already using. I'll also tell you about how you can access help at no cost from our deployment experts at Microsoft as you roll out Windows 10. Just about every organization is either midstream or complete with their move to Windows 10. In fact, what we're seeing is more than 65% of all commercial PCs have now been upgraded, and the rate of deployment just continues to accelerate. Now, if you've started and are blocked and the majority of your PCs are still on Windows 7, chances are you're concerned about one of the following things: compatibility of the apps and the hardware that you manage. Maybe you're not ready to move to the cloud services like Office 365, Azure Active Directory, or Microsoft Intune. Or maybe you just don't know where to start and you need someone to help guide you through the process. The good news is we can help on all fronts. First, we've introduced new tools with desktop analytics to make data-driven decisions for the systems that are ready to upgrade, leveraging compatibility data from hundreds of millions of PCs and devices and their apps. Application compatibility is not the challenge that it used to be. We've been working with IT teams around the world validating more than 250,000 applications in the process. And you know, for every 1,000 apps that we test that work in Windows 7, less than 2 have had compatibility issues with Windows 10. To be precise, that's 1/16 of 1% of the applications that we have validated have compatibility issues with Windows 10. That's just incredible. If you find one of those rare apps that does not work with Windows 10, you can contact our engineers in the Desktop App Assure program at no cost, and we'll help you debug and fix any compatibility applications. Check out more details at aka.ms/desktop-app-assure. Next, if you're concerned about moving to the cloud as a part of your Windows 10 upgrade, don't worry. You can leverage your existing tools like Configuration Manager, Active Directory, and the Volume Activation Services as you move to Windows 10. That said, moving to the cloud should still be a priority, and there are some huge benefits, like using OneDrive for backup and secure file access across all your devices, Windows Autopilot to configure new PCs directly from the cloud without needing to reimage them, and desktop analytics to provide data-driven device readiness reports that save you testing time as you stay current with the latest Windows 10 updates. As you move to Windows 10, our recommendation is that you also deploy the cloud-connected Office 365 ProPlus apps. And moving forward, the majority of the new management value will come through the cloud. You really do need to add Intune to your Configuration Manager deployments to get the power and intelligence of the Microsoft Cloud. Next, if you feel stuck or blocked, or are just looking for personal assistance, we just launched a new FastTrack service to help you upgrade to Windows 10. Our engineers can help you create upgrade task sequences to drive scalable and automated Windows 10 deployment through Configuration Manager. Check out aka.ms/fasttrack-windows-10 to learn more. With the January 2020 Windows 7 end of support date in sight, in-place upgrades are a great option for quickly and reliably moving to Windows 10 for your current devices. And if you're replacing PCs as a part of your deployment, or you need to reimage some of your PCs, the Desktop Deployment Center walks you through all the core tasks and options in a way that sets you up to take advantage of cloud automation in the future, such as Windows Autopilot and Intune. This includes considerations for Office as well as options to implement cloud-driven services to round out and modernize your deployment with Azure Active Directory, OneDrive, and more. As you do your upgrades, do it in a way that's efficient today and sets you up for the future. I'll give you a brief introduction into what to expect as you follow the deployment process, Will, and you can keep following this series to get a deep dive on each step and the corresponding tools and processes. These steps will apply to just about any client operating system deployment, and most of these can be worked on in parallel to save time. Okay, starting at the top, device and app readiness. This is the first step, and it relates to taking an inventory of your devices and apps to verify compatibility. For that, we've built new tools with desktop analytics, which is available now, to inventory and analyze your apps and devices. We tap into our compatibility intelligence and signal that comes from hundreds of millions of PCs around the globe to understand both apps and drivers and to assess the readiness of your desktop estate. We'll even help you assess the compatibility of your custom line of business applications. For Office add-in and macro inventory and assessment, you can use the Readiness Toolkit for Office. And if you have Configuration Manager, these capabilities for add-ins are built into the hardware inventory and will give you a custom dashboard to track add-in compatibility and device readiness for newer versions of Office. Both these tools are heavily integrated with Configuration Manager and your device collections, so once devices are ready, you can target them for the deployment. Again, This is where if you hit a snag and find any incompatible apps or Office add-ins, our Desktop App Assure program can help you at no cost. Just call us. Directory and network readiness is the next step. And here, if you haven't already, you'll want to make sure your deployment infrastructure is up to date. Then optionally, you can implement Azure Active Directory for identity and access management, but you can also continue to use your on-prem Active Directory, as I said before. And then you'll want to get your network ready for moving system images, application packages, and user files across your network, and to support later deployment and migration activities. We've done a lot of work building network optimization, spanning traffic optimization, peer-to-peer, throttling and differential updating across Config Manager, Office, and Windows to minimize the impact on your network. One of my favorite dashboards shows all the bandwidth that we've saved in Configuration Manager with delivery optimization globally. And here's what one looks like that you can see in your own Configuration Manager console. Next is Office and Line of Business Application Delivery. This ensures that your apps are ready for automated deployment, and you'll need to be familiar with the click-to-run Office deployment and your configuration options. In fact, we just published a deep dive on Office deployment at aka.ms/officeitseries that walks you through all the updates for preparing, upgrading, and managing Office. But beyond Office, you'll want all your other apps packaged up and ready for automated deployment. Next on the wheel is user files and settings migration. And this is necessary in PC replacement scenarios, and you can use the user state migration tool as a part of Configuration Manager or your MDT task sequences at deployment time. This step is often a timing bottleneck for PC replacement due to the physics involved in transferring sometimes hundreds of gigabytes per PC in each direction. Now, if you're using OneDrive, you won't have to worry about this networking issue, which is another reason to move to the cloud. Now, you might be asking yourself, how do I get my users' existing files into the cloud? OneDrive Known Folder Move is a new option to backup and sync user documents, pictures, and desktop files at scale into the cloud ahead of your deployment. Security and compliance is the next area, and this is an area that has a ton of upside when moving to Windows 10 and Office 365 ProPlus. You'll want to familiarize yourself with the new built-in capabilities and compare that with what you already have, then see if you can replace some of your bolt-on security options with just native Windows 10 capabilities. And cloud services like Microsoft Defender Advanced Threat Protection give you a unified platform for security hardening, post-breach detection, investigation, and response. It can also safeguard you against malicious email attachments, unsafe hyperlinks, and more. Plus, you can standardize this solution on both PCs and Macs. Now, this brings us to OS deployment and feature updates. As the next step that is really about upgrading your PCs, getting OS images deployed, or customizing Windows installs with your apps, policies, and configurations to a business-ready state. A lot of the heavy lifting will be done using Configuration Manager, task sequences, and infrastructure. For new PCs, you can use Windows Autopilot to get them to business-ready with the apps and policies needed, all without having to re-image those devices. Now, a big change with desktop management is how Windows and Office are updated and serviced. These new models mean you can continually bring new capabilities, experiences, and protections to your users without waiting or bolting on more things to manage like you might have done in the past. Now, there are a couple of concepts that are core to Windows and Office as a service. The first is semi-annual feature updates, which deliver new capabilities in the fall and the spring of each year. And second, for Windows, there are monthly cumulative quality updates that contain security, reliability, and bug fixes. Our strong recommendation is for you to target the second half releases of Windows at a minimum and move to monthly updates of Office 365 ProPlus so that your users continually receive new Office capabilities. Finally, user communication and training is critical to driving usage of new capabilities for enhancing teamwork, communication, security, and more. Before broad deployment is targeted to users outside of early adopter rings, user communication and training should be planned to drive desired changes in how people use new capabilities in Office, Windows, or other line of business applications and services. Here we also have services from our Microsoft FastTrack team to help drive user adoption and get the most from your upgrade. Okay, so now you know what's new and different, and I've walked you through your deployment options and how we can help your team if you encounter compatibility challenges, or if you just want expert help from our FastTrack engineers as you upgrade. And once you've updated to Windows 10, you'll want to continue on your path to cloud-based management to get all the benefits of device management, Azure Active Directory, Office 365 ProPlus, OneDrive, and more. And just to emphasize again, you really do need to move to the cloud for modern productivity, deployment, management, and security. You've seen all the deployment considerations around the world to give you an idea of the steps and tools that we've built to help you get deployed using your preferred processes and tools. Now, I encourage you to keep watching as we go deeper on each step in the deployment wheel on Desktop Deployment Essentials here on Microsoft Mechanics. In fact, next up is Device and App Readiness. Thanks for watching.